All right, guys, out here trying to get some brush work done. You can see there sure is plenty of it out here. But I'm having a challenge with this bucket edge here. It is not really grabbing a hold of stuff the way I want it to. You know, it's just a smooth bucket. It's good for back dragging and, you know, picking stuff up. But as far as tearing out all this brush goes, it's just not really cutting it. So I got just the thing. Ready? Here goes. Hey, did it work? What do you think of that? Well, that ought to make a huge difference, huh? Yeah, man. Let's get this thing going and give it a shot, huh? Fire it up and see it in action. Thank you. Well, gonna do some cleaning up, of course, but could you believe there's a barn in there? Not bad. I tell you what, that ratchet rake is bad to the bone. See that? Oh yeah. Sweet. Well, all right. Right on, ratchet rake. It sure did well. And I thought I'd give you a little look-see as to our progress out here. Goes. We found the barn. Corded all the way through to the driveway. We got this fire started up tonight. See if we can get this thing torched up. But the brushwork wasn't even the hardest part. It was all this trash I found out here. You know, be real careful brushing around. Tons of wire in there. I mean, oh my goodness. You grab a hold of a chunk of barbed wire, you know, around one of your hydraulic lines or something. My goodness, you can do some damage. There was a big old, about a 5-foot snake sitting underneath this piece of tin when I found it. Pretty dangerous, really, honestly pretty dangerous. You got to be real careful. But, I'll tell you what, I was struggling so much. I mean, every time I'd hit a bush or something, I just knew that there was going to be some chunk of dangerous metal in there somewhere. And it got me thinking, man, I was just ranting and made me want to preach a sermon someday. And we'll call it something like what to do with trash. You know, put it where it belongs. You know, just like you wouldn't take all of your garbage and throw it into your bushes. Because you might not see it, but it's still there. And it's just something that you're going to eventually have to come and dig up and deal with anyway. So take it while you can before it gets all overgrown and put it where it belongs, in a trash can. Take it to the dump. Get rid of it. Same thing, man. That's what the Lord does in our life. The blood of Jesus doesn't want to just bury over all the garbage in our life, but he wants to take the trash and he wants to put it where it belongs. You know, you throw it in the trash and you get rid of it. And, you know, the garbage of my life was stuff like, you know, I needed drugs and alcohol to be happy. I could never be happy without it. Or, you know, any number of lies, you know, that I believed and that people continue to believe in their life. And we just let Jesus take those thoughts. The Bible says taking every thought captive and bringing it under the obedience of Jesus Christ. And we realize that to obey the Lord is oftentimes, yes, you know, following a list of do's and don'ts, of course, you know, doing what's right, not doing what's wrong. But obedience also becomes taking those garbage thoughts and those lies and willfully taking them captive, bringing them under the obedience of Christ and throwing them right where they belong, treating it like the garbage that it is. So any lies that try to get whispered into your ear, you're not good enough, you know, you can't be healed, you can't be free, throw that stuff in the garbage where it belongs so that it doesn't become some huge problem you got to deal with later. It's kind of a fun thing. Come check out these guineas. Look at these. We got little Jack with us. Hey, Jack. How you doing, Jack? You good? Yeah, you're good. How about Charlotte? Charlotte, you good? Oh, hi. Oh, hi there. Oh, yeah. Jack and Charlotte. Mm-hmm. Charlotte's the blondie. Mm-hmm. They got big sister over here. Hi, SA. And they're just keeping watch. They're keeping watch over the guineas. Huh? Did you ever see a happier guinea? Look at these birds. Oh, man. Oh, man. Are you guys just sitting there grubbing on your foliage? Huh? You got your little bird run here? Charlotte? we're training Charlotte. You don't get to attack the fence and scare your guineas. She's gonna be a good little guinea watchdog, huh, sweetheart? Anywho, yep. Praise the Lord. If you guys haven't seen it yet, you gotta check out our guinea video. Another beautiful night. Happy Wednesday, everybody. God bless you.